I did not do it for hatred. But I truly hate the devil, I cannot debate or fake it. I was asked a question and the asker thought it hard. If I was facing death and I could ask one thing of God, I would ask for every to be free here and abroad. And to be rightfully celebrated as a child of God. And to be rightfully celebrated as a child of God.
Black superhero. Every block, every hood, every city, every ghetto. Need a black superhero. Our own kind took nip from us. Money still we and God we trust. Truthfully we envy, so why we so envious? And why our own kind envy us? Pac said it's hard, but we gotta keep our head up. Keep going even though we know we fed up. Tell attention, cause we ain't careful where we all pay attention. I need all my real soldiers on the front line, fighting for the right just one time. It's too unstoppable together at the same time, with the same mind. Yeah, we're born to be high and always above what's beneath us. So,
every block, every hood, every city.
Black superhero.
Every block, every hood, every city, every ghetto.
Need a black superhero.
I'm talking bulletproof. Kind of suit, reflect the struggle that they put us through, with the strength to fight the power like Chuck D a do, with the insight to be equal, no disguise, needed a voice that finds reason to multiply people in the streets for the cause, marching on Washington miners, we'll be walking through walls, type of superhero show up when ain't no one to call, better shielded from them shields that been killing us all, high beams for eyes to peep the villains in the door, power of resolution for a war with even start, the knowledge to build and grow where they live and take care of the kids and the older folk, the clean cause they need it most. Politic with the kings about economic growth. Kill PTSD cause mental health ain't a joke. Feed the hungry and dope. Everyone would know everywhere we go.
Every block, every hood, every city, every ghetto.
Need a black superhero.
Every block, every hood, every city, every ghetto.
Need a black superhero.
For you, but it's for me.
Freestyle's finest. Boss.
Yeah.
DJ Drama.
Never let a wishbone grow where backbone should. Belly been taking the dash on wood. Stand pain is the back end good. Got sense, but they act no good. Shot through the lot of the starstruck. Hop in the rider, we took in the truck of a in the truck, and they all. They might say what's up when they see me around the city, but really no reason to talk much. Dinner and nice guy, but no nice guys here. I'm toe tagging, no Bill Bo Baggins, y'all coming up short. Take a recess, this a heat check. Yeah, shorty let me quick as a clear with a pre-check. It's lifestyle, not for you, but it's for me. Seen it myself for years, the vision is mine alone. Just me, myself, no peers. Yeah.
That's some high quality breathing now. Who had this? What is you?
Break hard like habits, no days off, no Sabbath, no snakes in my yard, no rabbits. Never let a wishbone grow where backbone should. Belly been taking the dash on wood. Stand payment, the back end good. Got sense, but they act no good. Send the same money to Sudan, I could probably feed the club for a year or two. Stuck between something and a miracle. For real. Let's explore the moment. Ain't outside there agoraphobic. If you see me live, you would know it. Jumping on my do aerobics, buy a site, P90X. Boss like we write the checks now. Floss like we like the flex. Bust down, bust down, bust down. AMG, no bust now. Amiri jeans, SB dummies with a fiends T, no button down. Respectfully, that's for me, you don't round if you wanna. Round if you wanna. Slice style, not for you, but it's for me. Bye.
Posse. Pause, I'ma go without the ad-libs. In the booth and I'm like poofing, I don't understand what got in me. Got a couple of truths that I bust out the roof from ready to battle my enemy. And you rappers just on my identity. And I really know why you ain't feeling me.
Look at me. Air traffic control. This is the tower. Looking at it. Ain't like that? I don't look like a little air traffic control person. The shirt make me not look like it. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. A snitch. I heard that win. No cramps. We the champions. No canes. We doing numbers. Bring home victory straight out the huddle. I met the plug introduced to my brother. My squad's a pretty. You want some from Kane? We doing numbers. Gang in the building, we taking it over. Caught it from motors. I mean, Kane down there charging you $20 now. Kane's down there charging you $20 now.
Oh,
another one. Oh,
another one.
Oh, you ain't think I had your money? Mm-hmm. You ain't think I had it? City girl. What's going on in there?
Yeah.
What's going on in there? There's a lot of hip shaking.
Take a look around where we touch the town, not the way, stomping in my big black J's.
Hello? Hello? From Cali to Singapore, every day I'm seeing more, in the temple as we rock up tempo instrumental. I saw a dream in a dream, then I woke up. Put the dream team together. Now we know All right, well, as soon as I finish my game, I'll be able to knock you out. The Patriots. I don't know, man. I mean, these be a whole bunch of new users. I don't be knowing these niggas. That's why I be trying to get different people from different leagues, you know, so. Like, some of the people gonna still be the same, but you know, some of them you gonna be like, I don't know who this nigga is.
Alright.
Season goal comes with higher rewards.
It ain't easy breaking away or being a great. They slamming the door, I'm jumping the gate. Cause a starving stomach like being punched in the face. And an instrumental with the last time that I ate. Full from all of the base. My ace boom goon, big son told me about the game. 20 years later, know my name. King crown me lounge in the back of the spot. Pay homage to an underground peasant, climb to the top. Funny style. On elevators could never fade us. I peep data saying anytime they congratulate us. Goggles is worn and bottles is popping. I'm beyond Sanders, don't hate us. This ice bucket dropping over their head with it. They shoot a crib with it. You either fight or flight. I ain't one for the ledge living. I do it for the one that died with fed millions. With soul food flowed and stock my bare kitchen. I'm liberated. I drew a play that they ain't illustrated. I make a move they gladly imitated. I ain't flattered, I'm a dragon to your paper castle. The Alpha and Omega, promise it ain't nothing after. A new beginning, my catalog like James Earl Jones, the ever-living.
We are about 15 or so miles northwest of world-famous Miami Beach as we are set for football at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens. Today we get the season started with an AFC East tilt right off the bat between the New England Patriots and the Miami Dolphins. Here's a punter, Thomas Morstead, to get this one started. And we are underway from Hard Rock Stadium. Jones looking to throw right away. That swung out wide to Harris. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
From the 29, Jones. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front.
The touch and timing are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
This defense looking for an early stop. This is third down and 6. Jones. The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. And he's going to come up a bit short. He needed to get to the 35 for the first, but he only makes it to the 34. They're going for it. This is Harris. And they are going to stop him on fourth and one as they'll wind up going backwards. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And on the opening drive of the afternoon, the defense forces a turnover on downs. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. They'll run here with Raheem Mostert. And a hard-working run here as he's got it inside the 20, down to the 17. Give him 15 yards on that one, and the Dolphins have a first down. Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he decided, hey, I'm going to hand this off. Got a good gain out of it.
And you know you need good blocking up front in order to gain yardage, but every one of these RPOs, if you do it right and they look the same, whether it's handed off inside or the quarterback keeps it, that allows you to fool the defense so often, and in this case, fooled him with the inside run.
Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. Two are going to throw. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Marching in for the sack, Matthew Judon.
A move to New England from Baltimore suited Matthew Judon nicely with 12 and a half sacks in his first year of a new four-year contract with the Patriots. That was a new career high for him, seventh in the NFL, and the most for a Patriot since 2015.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Oh, that's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
Sanders' kick is good, and the Dolphins will jump out to
a nice tail hurt. A whopper. What the fuck is that? Y'all about to make you a waffle. They got a waffle in there. So basically, you're telling me you about to eat the waffle? Basically, you're telling me you about to eat the waffle? Getting the syrup somewhere. I just had to think the syrup somewhere. I thought about it. Oh, yeah. I thought about it when I opened the box. I was like, nah.
Squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week one. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I should like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First,
now I was thinking about fucking with it, but I was like,
see that the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet when you do have injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people. What a great game to sell right out of the gate.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Noah Igbinoghene. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown.
Coaches preach all the time about opportunities and taking advantage of them. And he did exactly that. I used to have a coach tell us all the time, a lost opportunity is never regained. Well, no regrets here. He picked that one off and took it to the house.
Right after through the raindrops, up and good. To 10-0. So an early 10-0 lead for him now as they kick it away. At the line, ready to go. They'll look to get something started. They need to, down 10-0 early as they've got it first and 10. Jones throw there, complete to Myers. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. It needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
They'll wind up getting just a yard out of it, and that'll bring up second down. Throwing Jones. And this will be caught at the 30. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. That one covers 29 yards, first down. Harris running straight ahead, and he's got it down to the 28.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defense in front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
And that one blown up quickly. And he's going to be stopped before he can even get started. This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down moment. Back to throw. Jones. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. That time, Bradley Chubb shooting in there for the sack. Not the start to this one that any quarterback would want or envision. Remember, he had the pick six, and here he ends up on his backside.
And you have to wonder to yourself, okay, after throwing the pick six, did he get too careful with the football and not deliver downfield and take that sack? They've got to make sure that he's really into this game.
And that one will be no good. He never had it online. It's well wide to the left, and they will not cut into that 10-point lead.
Now, if this was a clear day in September, I'd say this is well within his range. I'd feel very confident about this kick, but let's be honest about it. In these elements, the difficulty level gets ratcheted up by at least a factor of five.
Tua now on first down. He's going to fire one deep over the middle, and that will fall incomplete. Oh, they took a shot there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Tua finding Gesicki there for Dolphin first. On first and 10, it's Mostert. He's got it to the 43 here. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Tua sets up to pass it. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone.
Yeah, I'm going to let
it's maybe. Kyler Duggar
who picks it,
and the Patriots are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. Now a play fake here on first down, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Jones over the middle complete. That's Myers. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And third and eight now. And in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. Here's Jones to throw on third down. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first.
Yeah, these are the types of plays they're going to need to hit on if they're going to get back into this game. It hasn't been the greatest of first halves, but this is a nice throw here on third down, and they keep the drive going.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Open man, the tight end Henry. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. They go right back to him for 20 and a first.
Hunter Henry's now in his second season with the New England Patriots. And
I'm in a game right now. I'm doing a game.
And really emerges rookie quarterback Mac Jones' favorite target, especially when they needed points in the red zone. Stays his favorite here and picks up a first down.
Yeah, going to tip.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Quick completion to Henry. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 32-yard line. They give him 14 yards that time and a flash shut of downs. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Off the play fake. Jones. And he can't find a receiver and he's brought down. Emmanuel Ogba that time able to drop him for a loss. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. 10-0 our score. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Another try after the first down sack. Jones setting up the screen. Harris. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40. Ninth play of the drive now. Third and a country mile. Operating from the gun. Jones. A hit as he throws there. Incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
And now Nick Folk, his career long, 56 yards. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. And I tell you what, he got it from 58. That had lots of leg behind it. That also a career-long kick for the veteran, Charles.
Yeah, how about what he just got done there? We always knew he had a big leg. But how about everything coming together perfectly on that one? Great leg swing, and bang that one through.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity.
Not
him. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. Looking to throw again on second down. Tua. He'll hit Mostert again here. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a first down. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. They'll roll him out right. In a double coverage, and it's intercepted.
So the first thing that comes to my mind is, why didn't they just sit on the lead and take it to the locker room? They're in good shape.
Absolutely. And from this spot on the field, now you've given the other side a chance for points here going into intermission.
Yeah, you changed the momentum of the game, and it's something you did not need to do.
Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Throwing again on second down. Jones. Henry's got it out on the left side. And they are into field goal range now as he's got the first down at the 26. Off play action. Jones rolling to his left. That's caught by Myers. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. It'll be a gain of 16 for number 16. A chance for a first touchdown drive of the year. It's first and goal. to throw again.
Man, this is it. I didn't even make you run after that. God damn it.
The first half is winding down, and the Patriots have a chance to tie the game here in the final seconds of the half. Extra point up and good by Folk, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. Throw right side, going to be caught here by Waddle. And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40. Couple of Alabama guys here, Tua to Waddle for the Miami first. Tua, the final shot before half. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. They don't want to repeat a first down. They'll keep it on the ground. And he will perhaps get back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. And time has run out on this first half. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we go up to Orlando now and hand it over to Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. And we'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. Here comes the return from the very back of the end zone. A lane opens here. He's past the 30. He's at the 40. The 20.
He's out of here. With the kick return, dude. From 100, like 109-yard kick return on the move. He's nuts. They're out.
The special teams coaches, that theme of being aggressive continues to come through, doesn't it? When they move the kickoff back to the 35, it was going to cut down on the number of opportunities. But you get a special guy.
Range
of emotions, maybe like, oh no, don't, and then all of a sudden you see him break it and you're like, yeah, way to go.
Yeah, sometimes you have to remind your head coach that he approved the green light for bringing it out from deep in the end zone, and that's exactly why he did.
And he's gonna be out of bounds.
He tried to break one back. That ball was trying to, he was rolling it.
That strong return has set them up nicely for this drive, and we all know the next score is gonna have a major impact on this game.
Meanwhile, Jones throw into the hands of Henry here. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. Nice his way forward here, but just 3 yards on the play. Second down. The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. Looking to throw. Jones. It's brought in by Harris. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. It'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And that's going to lead to a 3rd and 12. And see what they have drawn up here. A little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down. Now throwing on 3rd down there, but he cannot connect.
The goal is certainly to try to make a big play happen and climb back into this game, but you have to be careful. you overdo it, you could turn it over and hurt your team.
And he missed
it.
It's no good. And this will stay at a 7-point game. Down here in the third quarter, obviously that's one they could have used.
Yeah, one of my favorite special teams coaches in the NFL told me what separates the kickers in the NFL versus the ones who are not, it's not the misses, it's the second miss in a row. The best kickers in the league, they don't miss two in a row. He's got to get his head back together in case he gets another shot.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
To his throw, caught by his receiver, Hill. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Oh, Jesus, what type of fucking throw was that? What type of fucking throw was that, too? God damn.
So this offense moving the ball well, trying to open up a two-score lead here in the third quarter, but now potentially a play that could have big ramifications.
Yeah, you've driven the ball down the field, things are looking up, but it takes just one bad decision to throw things off the rails.
That'll give them 8 that time, and it'll be second in a couple. They hand this off to Harris. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Second and 10, third quarter of the season opener. To throw. Jones. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Torn back across his body. Picked up by Channon Timber. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six.
The rookie. The pick six.
Well, Charles, just some visibly frustrated players and coaches on that sideline right now because those halftime adjustments didn't work. The turnover problems continuing here in the second half. And the defense now sitting pretty comfortably as a result of that pick six.
That's a great observation, too, Brandon, because they did make adjustments at halftime. But how about this other group staying a step ahead despite whatever happened in that other locker room? No surprise they're leading, and it's appropriate that those defenders got to add to the lead directly.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Pats at the line, ready to go. Remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go-around.
And sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, oh, yeah, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Looking left sideline, incomplete.
Well, he certainly didn't like what he saw at all from the coverage on his primary reads, and he didn't even have any luck trying to get back to his safety valve. Give defense a credit. Coverage was in lockdown mode everywhere.
On second and 10, Jones, open man is Myers. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And that is incomplete. But the pressure there on third down, forcing the errant pass. Fourth down coming up.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought out the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down. Back to throw again. And they get Jones for the third time in this ballgame. Picked up by Javon Holland. And the Dolphins force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive. They score here, especially a touchdown, it's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
Get ready.
Second down, here's Mostert again. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down.
Now that's a nice play. Got me fired up, partner. But can they do it back-to-back plays? All the training that you go through as a defense for these situations, when you have to get the ball back, everything you go through, holding up the runner, raking at the football, getting to the passer, knocking it out of his hands, whatever way, they have to get the ball back.
Now can they stand tall again for a huge fourth quarter stop? They're able to find Gesicki as tight end. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. Might want to remember that third down play, 37 yards.
Even with the big lead here in the fourth, it still bombs away. And frankly, it's working. Why should they stop? Go ahead and keep firing away and gaining those yards.
This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30.
Well, this has certainly been a nice drive with the way they've spread the football around.
They even get
the fullback involved in the passing game. That's got to cause a lot of consternation on the defensive side. You got to cover him, too. That makes things really difficult.
Who are you taking care of?
The line of scrimmage. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here. Third and five. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks.
Who are the Dre guy?
Tagovailoa working out of the gun. Caught. It's Wilson.
Who the Dre guy?
About the 23-yard line.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn: find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think
Dre guy? Dre got the coach.
That indeed, picking up the first.
He won a league induction on Brett Hundley and Stephon Gilmore.
Here's Tua. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one.
No replay for us for like 3 years or so.
Conversions for them on this drive, but right now they need 5 yards on this third down try.
Clint Moore and Nick Cross is a superstar.
Now with that interception, you feel like we got a ball game again. Remember, a two-score contest and still time left here in the fourth.
And in the old days, not too long gone either, throwing the ball here would have been an absolute no-no. But the way the game's played now, throwing it makes sense. You just have to be careful when you put it in the air.
Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. It'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter.
They got a good start
there on first down. They've got to have this drive.
No doubt about it. Down a couple of scores. They have to find a way to put it in the end zone.
Explosive plays.
That would be the key to this drive.
Clinton Moore and Nick Cole.
Now Jones. That's complete into the hands of Myers. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. 14 yards is the pickup there on a New England first down.
I don't know who he is. I think Nick Cross is a strong suit. I don't know.
Throwing Jones. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Brandon Jones picking it off, and the Dolphins are going to take possession of the football. After the turnover, it's Tua. And going deep for Hill. And this one is incomplete.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest. With a guy with that type of speed, you do so. Send him deep. Try to throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they run successful.
To throw once more on second and 10. Tua, and they'll get this on the screen to Mostert. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Sure, though. Look at
that. That was a beautifully executed screen pass. Let the rushers get upfield. The blocking forms in front. Lofted it to the runner. And now, not only does he have open space in front of him, he's got an escort as well, and they pick up big yardage.
You got what you wanted.
On first down, Tagovailoa. He's got it. Touchdown, Dolphins. Raheem Mostert. A 24-yard touchdown. And the Dolphins are closing in on a winning start to the year as they extend their fourth quarter lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And a lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. Marcus Jones going to elect to bring this one out. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And they knew coming in that this would be a tough place to go in and win a season opener. But this has just been a performance, to be frank, not to be proud of here as they trail big in this fourth quarter. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws. They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
To throw again on second down, Jones. The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. Work now for Jones and the Patriots here after the sack. It's third and long. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. Ball had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Desperation time now. Here's Jones. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's knocked away and incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And defensively, that might just seal a week one victory. Tua getting it quickly out to Waddle. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line.
Let's go!
The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here.
God damn, you say, oh, one time, I did it three times. The fuck, you out of count?
Season, but this was a division game here in week one, and to come through with a 1-0 start against the division.
I ain't scratching nothing.
A little something extra headed for the rest of the season.
Yeah, let's pile it all into one game, right? Opening the season, and you open within the division. You knew the motivation
was
going to be on both sidelines. One just executed better and earned the win.
So for the Dolphins, that'll be a happy locker room as they start the season 1-0. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Baltimore Ravens. Meanwhile, for the Patriots, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll be on the road next week as they travel to Pittsburgh to take on the Steelers.